Ciel Rouge, Le Vermontant, it's a novel set in 1832 in Ireland and in America, and it's a story about a man who has to leave everything behind him because he does one thing in a very rash moment. He kills a man and has to leave, and it's about this spiral of violence that comes out of this one act, and we end up with this enormous tragedy out of this one moment. And so the book explores ideas of violence and ideas of power, and how the kind of powers that operate in the world, and how he tries to make good and to come back home to Ireland, but the world maybe is stacked against him. By watching a documentary on television, I saw this story, a true story about these men who had travelled to Pennsylvania in 1832. They had left Donegal to work on the railroad, and sometime in the summer of 1832 they had arrived, and by August they were all dead, and they were all buried in a mass grave, and their story was covered up and hidden. And they disappeared into history. They disappeared into the abyss of time. Nobody remembered them. Nobody knew about that they were dead. The story was hidden. And then it was discovered by two American historians, and they started researching this, and they started doing excavations in the area, and a documentary was made. And I saw the documentary, and I found that this was a really powerful idea, because there was, on one hand, the fact that I had grown up in the same area of Donegal where these men had come from, so I knew them. You know, even though they were 200 years old, or I could hear them, I could see them, and I had been to school maybe with people who had been related to them. So I felt that this was this incredible gift to a novelist, this thing that had come out of history, out of the abyss of time, and had been given to you. And I knew I needed to write about it, but within that, there were so many resonances about the present time. The idea of powerlessness, and the idea that that we're all weak in some way, and that there's always greater forces shaping our lives. And as I was writing this book, Ireland was going through its economic crisis, and I could see the effects everywhere in Ireland. I could see it in my own family. I lost my job, and newspaper I worked for collapsed while I was writing this book. And so I think my anger with what was happening in the world was put into this novel. I thought it'd be great fun. I love the idea of sitting on stage and talking with French writers and Irish writers, combining completely different viewpoints and somewhere in the middle finding that we think the same. I had a session the other day where I found that the writer I was with, that I could have answered his questions and he could have answered my questions, and yet the books that we write are so different, so completely different. And so you find that there are these really interesting similarities beneath the two different cultures, that writers are really the same and we're motivated by the same instincts. You know, the theme of the festival is change, and all fiction is change. All our lives are change, and we move through our lives thinking that things remain the same, but the reality is everything changes, and things change greatly. And in my book, and in my second book, which has just come out in Ireland, it's all about the idea of change, that our lives can be altered in just a single moment, and be altered in this vast way that we can't get back to, and we can never go back to. And yet at the same time, I like the idea that nothing changes. The human nature never changes. And that we think things change, but maybe they don't so much. And that maybe when you look at things historically, you start to see that things don't really change at all very much. There are immutables. There are things such as death, such as time, such as the size of the universe, the objectivity of it, that we're in. And that we try to make sense of, and that none of this changes. And so our lives are all changed, but within this universe of no change. And I think that's a really interesting thing to write about and to explore. Well, right now, this is like the cliche, but I'm reading the Proust. I'm reading the whole six novels, and I'm reading the second one at the moment. and it's my challenge for this year, because it's so great and it's so intimidating that every year I go, oh, not this year, but this year I decided that I'm reading it, and I love it. It's incredible. It's so good. It would nearly stop, make you not want to write ever again, because it's just so intimidating.